Welcome back to our SS Biology. Today we are going to discuss about a very interesting topic, chromosomal mutation. We all know the basic structure of chromosome, that is a long arm and a short arm. Short arm known as P arm and the long arm known as Q arm. Now, what are the chromosomal mutation? Chromosomal mutation, also known as chromosomal aberration, are variation from normal, which is a wild type condition in chromosome structure or chromosome number, which involve losses, addition, rearrangement of genes in the genome. In bacteria, archaea and eukarya, chromosomal mutation arises spontaneously or can be induced experimentally by certain chemical or radiation. Chromosomal mutation traditionally were detected by genetic analysis, that is, by observing changes in the linkage arrangement of gene. The study of normal and mutated chromosome and their behavior is called cytogenetics. A more precise description of chromosomal mutation is now possible in case where genome sequence can be compared. However, chromosome mutations are more common than we thought once, and they contribute significantly to spontaneously aborted pregnancy and stillbirth, as well as to some form of cancer. So, it is the significant cause of developmental disorder. So, chromosomal aberration is divided into two groups: variation in chromosome structure and variation in chromosome number. Today we will discuss in detail about variation in chromosome structure. Four common type of chromosomal mutation involve the changes in chromosomal structure: deletion and duplication, both of which involve a changes in the amount of DNA on a chromosome. And the third one is inversion, which involves changes in orientation of a chromosome. And the last one is translocation, that involves the changes in location of chromosomal segment. All four classes of chromosomal structural mutation begin with one or more break in the chromosome. If a break occurs within the gene, then the function of that gene may be lost. Now, first one is deletion. Deletion is a chromosomal mutation in which the part of chromosome is missing. A deletion starts where the break occurs in the chromosome. Break can be induced by the agent such as heat, radiation, virus, chemical. Because a segment of chromosome is missing, deletion mutation cannot revert to the wild type state. The consequence of the deletion depends on the gene or the part of the gene that have been removed. For an example, in diploid organism, an individual heterozygous for a deletion may be normal, but if the homologue contain recessive allele that have deleterious effect, the consequence can be severe. Several disorders due to chromosomal deletion. First is Cry-Do-Chat syndrome. Here, the deletion of part of short arm of chromosome 5. Baby look like a moonfish and a crying like a cat. And the second one is Prader-Willi syndrome. Here, the deletion of part of the long arm of chromosome 15. Here, the patient with mental retardation, obesity, etc. And the next one is the deletion of 9p21 gene that encode P16 cyclin DKN2A that actually leads to lung cancer. Now, a duplication is a chromosomal mutation that results in the doubling of segment of chromosome. There are the three type of duplication. First one is tandem duplication, when the mutation generate duplicated segment that are adjacent to each other with the order of the gene in both segment the same as the order of the original. Here BC just become duplicated here. The second one is reverse tandem, when the order of gene in the duplicated segment is the opposite of the order of the original. BC become duplicated, but in a reverse way, BC become CB. The last one is terminal tandem, when the duplicated segment are arranged in tandem at the end of chromosome. Now, phenotypic, there are the various phenotypic effect. Duplication of particular genetic region can have a unique phenotypic effect, as in the bar mutant on the X chromosome of Drosophila on 16A segment. This bar mutation should not be confused with bar body. Bar I mutation denoted by capital B. It is a dominant mutation. Here B+B+, which is a wild type, normal eye formation. Here facet means the compound eye of Drosophila. Here we can see that 16A is present once in a time in X chromosome. And second, BB+, this is heterozygous bar. 16A is duplicated in one X chromosome and facet number reduced to 358. The third one is BB, that is homozygous bar. In 2X chromosome, 16A become duplicated. And the last one is BDB+, B double bar. 16A duplicated 2 times. Here we can see that 16A duplicated in 2 times. Here facet number become decreases to 45 and it's look like a bar. The position of duplication determined facet effect. Next, the third type of mutation is inversion. An inversion is a chromosomal mutation that result when a segment of a chromosome is excised and then reintegrated at an orientation 180 degree from the original orientation. Inversion can be homozygous, where Both pair of homologous chromosome carry inversion of the same nature, and heterozygous, where one chromosome in a pair of homologous chromosome is structurally normal and other carry an inversion. Now, this inversion are two type. One is paracentric and another one is pericentric. We will discuss about this paracentric and pericentric in detail. Here one segment, here we can see that here break is occur here, and one segment is excised and rotate 180 degree and again rearranged. Now what happened in paracentric inversion? If centromere is outside the inversion, then the inversion is called the paracentric inversion. Okay, what happened? This is the normal chromosome and this one is inverted chromosome. Okay, and this is the inversion loop. Loop formation occur only in heterozygous condition. Okay, here in normal chromosome A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. But here the inversion occur. Here the gene product A, D, C, B. Actually the inversion occur this region. This is B, C, D in normal case. But in inverted chromosome, this is D, C, B. But if the inverted segment of chromosome does not include centromere, this is called the paracentric. This inverted portion does not include centromere. So, what is the fate of gamete of inverted chromosome? And what about their viability? Here, from normal chromosome, normal product is formed A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H. Here we can see that first one. And in the second one, first is centromere here, and then A, B, then here the crossover happening. So A, B, C, D, then A, and again centromere. This is the dicentric product, okay, where two chromosome is present. The third one is here A, first is centromere, then A, D, C, B, E, F, G, H, which is normal. All the gene product is present. And the fourth one is H, G, F, E, B, then crossover happening here, then C, D, E, F, G, H. Here no centromere is present, so this is acentric. One more thing, here the deletion of E, F, G, H, and here the duplication of E, F, G, H. And again, here the deletion of A and here duplication of A. So, this duplication and deletion along with the acentric and dicentric product are not viable. They will not survive. Okay, now what happened in pericentric inversion? Here This is again the normal chromosome and this is the inverted chromosome. And this is inversion loop. Here, inversion occurs along with the centromere. This is centromere. Here, the inversion occurs along with the centromere. If centromere are contained within the inverted region, then the inversion said to be pericentric inversion. Here normal product A, B, C, then centromere, then D, E, F, G, H form, which is viable because all gene are present. But in the second case, A, B, then here crossover happening, C, centromere, D, A. Here deletion and duplication happening. Deletion of this E, F, G, H and A become duplicated. In third one, A, D, again centromere, C, B, E, F, G, H. All genes are present, so they are viable. And the last one, H, G, F, E, B, then crossover occur. Then C, then centromere, then D, E, F, G, H. Here, deletion and duplication. A is deleted and E, F, G, H is duplicated. So, these two products are inviable along with the deletion and duplication. But they all are monocentric. They all contain one centromere. Because of the presence of large deletion and duplication, the products are inviable. Now, translocation. What is translocation? A translocation is a chromosomal mutation in which there is a change in position of chromosome segment and the gene sequence. They contain to a different location in the genome. No gain or loss of genetic material is involved in translocation. Translocation are of three types. First one is non-reciprocal intrachromosomal translocation. If a chromosome segment changes position within the same chromosome, the translocation is a non-reciprocal intrachromosomal translocation, that is within the chromosome. Here B is change their position within the same chromosome. Next one is non-reciprocal interchromosomal translocation. If a chromosome segment is transferred from one chromosome to another, the translocation is said to be non-reciprocal interchromosomal translocation, that is between the chromosome. Here BC translocated here this to this chromosome. Third one is reciprocal translocation. If an exchange of segment between the two chromosome is involved, known as reciprocal translocation, this segment is exchanged with this segment. There is no change in the amount of genetic information. There are special pattern of translocation which is known as Robertsonian translocation. What happens here? The short arm of one acrocentric chromosome is exchanged with the long arm of another.
breaks occur close to the centromere, affecting the short arm of both chromosomes. The most frequent form of Robertsonian translocation in human occurs between chromosome 13 and 14 and chromosome 14 and 21. Okay. Translocation typically affect the product of meiosis. Here we can see that this is the normal chromosome N1 and this is the translocated one T1. Again, this is the normal chromosome N2 and this one is translocated one T2. There is three type of segregation. One is alternate segregation. Here in alternate segregation, N1, N2 and T1, T2 present. Both normal go to one pole and both translocated go to another pole. So they are viable. The second one is adjacent one. Each pole gets one normal and the opposite translocated. So they are the inviable, and adjacent to, they contain N1, T1, N2, T2. Each pole gets both the normal and translocated of the same chromosome. So these are inviable. Now, the most common class of mutation associated with the cancer is translocation. One of the example is chronic myelogenous leukemia, which involve chromosome 9 and 22 that are associated with reciprocal translocation. ABL located on chromosome 9 and BCR located on chromosome 22. ABL is translocated to chromosome 22 in patient with chronic myelogenous leukemia. The hybrid ABL-BCR gene is the oncogene responsible for chronic myelogenous leukemia. This fused chromosome called Philadelphia chromosome. Okay guys, if you like this video, please hit the like button and do subscribe and share with your friends. And if you have any doubt regarding this video, feel free to ask. Our comment section is open. And thank you.